I wouldn't exactly call death-defying, but definitely a dangerous escape. A brainchild of my own. A couple months ago, I came up with this idea, believe it or not, in a dream. I called a friend of mine who built some of my equipment for me, asked him to make me a miniature guillotine. For those of you that are familiar with a guillotine, you know that this is definitely much smaller than a standard guillotine. There's absolutely no way my head or neck is going to fit in that hole. Now, what I'm going to place through that hole is basically my hand and arm. In just a moment, I'm going to lock myself inside that guillotine. This guillotine is designed with a built-in timer. When I push the start button, I'm going to have about 30 seconds to free myself from that guillotine before the blade comes crashing down onto my arm. Now, you will see we have two little padlocks here. First thing I need to do, place my arm inside the guillotine. There we go, and get it locked down. Now these padlocks, I'm not going to use keys to unlock these padlocks. I'm actually going to attempt to pick the locks. And as I mentioned, I only have 30 seconds, that blade will come down whether I'm out or not. So hopefully this will go okay. You know what, April, if you could do me a favor, when I push the start button, could you play some, some exciting, suspenseful, escaping from the miniature guillotine kind of music. Alrighty, here we go, and go. Perfect. Oh! Wow. April, could you come out here and lend me a hand? you know what? I got some bad news, and I got some good news here.
What's the bad news?
Well, the bad news is I appear to have cut my hand off. Good news is, though, I'll be darned, it still seems to be working. You know what, while I try and fix this, reattach this, April, could you come out here and entertain these folks while I try and do something about this? I guess I'll use this hand to take the table off. In the meantime, a big